stones.
Hells. Something just woke up down here.
Thank you.
Be other survivors.
Notice nothing more than meets the eye. This is the pool that Finn came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye. Its casing crumbles beneath your hands, sloshing volatile brine as it collapses.
Jesus.
Brains. Curious. Curious.
We are here.
You've come to save us from this place.
From this place you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return!
They return.
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer. A minion of the Mind Flayers who abducted you.
Remove us
from this body!
From this case! Free us!
Notice edema, a swelling of the brain causing pressure where it strains against the shell of the skull.
Please, before they return!
They return.
Brain lifts from the skull, but you notice an opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient should it prove a threat.
We are free.
Our freedom is ours, friend.
The creature pauses, listening. Something behind your eyes seizes in recognition.
We must go to the helm.
At the helm, we are needed.
Us. We are us.
The brain tenses, as though querying an unseen advisor.
Do you not
hear it?
We will not survive here.
We are needed to
navigate.
We are needed to leave
this realm.
To the helm we go!
We are going to the helm.
images appear in your mind. A brain, a Githyanki warrior, and centuries of darkness. 1,000 years of humanoid history. Elves, dwarves, humans, and more flash behind your eyes. Visions rush past, a dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this? Squaw, you are no thrall. Vlakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. Imps block the path forward. You will assist me in destroying them. We must reach the helm before we transform. It is where we might gain control of the Ga'ath, the ship. Once in command, we will deal with our Geth captors. Who am I? Your only chance of survival. But you mine. Pains me to say it. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. As for that thing, it will remain tame as long as it believes we are thralls. It may be of use in the fight to come.
Thank you.
to the helm.
Thank you.
lend a hand, won't you, love? There's a rat in the kitchen. 10 red rats. And they're flying and they're clawing.
The creature reaches inside your mind, its thoughts rattling against yours. Something inside you squirms in recognition.
Friend, we will go to the helm now. In a realm where we have fled. We have fled to a realm called Avernus, first of the nine hells. We are escaping a great evil.
Thank you. nothing without knowing its purpose.
Isn't dead, but he's totally unresponsive.
Damn it! You! Get me out of this, Kelsey!
We have no time for stragglers. Satisfied? We need to go.
Leave the one. The one must be left.
Wait! There can't be. There has to be another way. Please!
It cannot be helped. Come.
Safe if she stays. Safe if we go.
We are nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
Brains. affects the nerves of the transporter. We must escape now.
Do it. We will deal with the Geich after we escape.
Connect the nerves.
Nerves?
We will connect them.
Intruders open! The furnace is ours!
Thank you.
Thank you. They can't hold forever. Come on. Blasted door, I... Stop! Not another step or I'll... Wait. It's you. You're the one who tried to free me on the ship. At least you made the effort.
Suddenly, you see what she sees. Feel what she feels. Confusion, resolve, and a hint of gratitude.
Ah! Did you feel that? You've got the same thing I do, in your head. The same. It must be that tadpole they put in our eyes. I assume that's what caused our minds to... cross. These things are going to consume us from the inside and turn us into mind flayers. You and I need a healer. Finding one won't be easy in this wilderness. We'll need supplies. I'm hoping something of use might be behind this door, but I've barely made a dent in it so far. Under ahead. I'm going to see what's at the top of this cliff. Hopefully there's no more of these creatures along the way. No, unless you count these monsters. You're the friendliest face so far. Just company for our final moments. But you're right. Whatever lies ahead will be a little less daunting with support. You can call me Shadowheart. Lead the way. Something the matter? We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly? Find a healer, and the sooner the better.
We've no solid leads right now, though. We'd best get hunting.
Thank you.
Survival isn't such a distant prospect.
there be even more that survived the crash?
More survivors? They're trying to dig somebody out of the wreckage.
Not sure, but we'd better find out.
Quickly! Shiva! Come on, dig! Faster! Get her out of there! Don't die! Don't die! Don't die!
The person they're trying to save, it's the creature from the ship. Still alive, but wounded. Your words fall on deaf ears. The creature's hold on them is too strong.
Monster! That's my daughter! She's dying! You did this! You want to kill her!
Suddenly, something convulses inside you. Your vision lurches sickeningly. You are one with your assailants, your minds fused together. They are frightened, lost. The creature in the wreckage is forcing them to attack you, controlling them like puppets. Its voice shivers across your brain, seeking access, trying to bend your will to its bidding. Presence in your mind gropes for purchase and finds the tadpole instead. You push back, taking advantage of a tremor of pain that cuts through the creature. As its influence wanes, your assailants lower their weapons, blinking in confusion.
Where are we? There was fire in the sky and then, oh God, Sona! What happened to my friend? God, I think you're right. It called out from the wreckage. Sounded just like my daughter, but she's been dead for years. That thing got into our heads, drove us mad. We wrecked our boat just trying to get close to it. What do we do now? We're nowhere. That's the point. Even with a boat, Baldur's Gate is days. Wait. You. I can feel you. Just like one of those things. You're one of them! There's something in your head. Please, we'll take our chances out here. Just leave us be.
We just broke a Mind Flayer's hold over its victims. How is that possible? The tadpoles? That's very likely. We're probably changing already. We need to deal with these tadpoles while we still can.
Approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now. If only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. Creature is on the brink of death, but there's still time. You'd give your life to save it, to nurse it back to health. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. You try to break through. But its mind is impenetrable. With a last surge of defiance, it slaps your efforts away. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it? If you want to keep that darling neck of yours. Now, I saw you on the ship, didn't I? Nod. Don't lie to me.
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm, the light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on? Just the same as me. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. A kindred spirit. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. A pleasure. So, do you know anything about these worms? No. Of that much we can be certain. These worms are already affecting me. I can feel it. Now, what to do about it? Well, getting out of here for a start. Then finding anyone who knows about these worms. I need an expert. Someone who knows how to control these things. Well, yes, of course. But first things first. You know, I was ready to go this alone. But maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
Somewhere to camp soon. deep grooves in the mud around that rock.
You're staring at me again. What do you want?
safe here. Keep moving.
Umberly speed you on your way. Won't trouble you any further.
Please, get away. We're building a raft. We'll bloody swim if need be. Just leave us be.
Unexpected. Last I saw you, you were lying in a crucible's worth of blood. An intellect devourer nibbling at your ear. Glad to see my eyes deceive me. I'm Gale. Well met. Very same. Traumatizing experience, if an instructive one.
Yes.
The ocular penetration by an illithid tadpole, which will end with our souls being snuffed like strands of weave caught in dead magic. Not to mention, you're staring at me like a Rashimi at a blackboard. You're no wizard, are you? There's a gust of weave about you, but it's a mere breeze. I need a tempest. It'll have to wait. The primary need is a healer. I take it you recall the insertion of the parasite? Are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it'll turn us into mind flayers? A process known as seramorphosis? It is to be avoided. I assume you're no accomplished healer either. Powerful cleric, maybe? Sadly, my studies of the arcane are on hold for the foreseeable future. This is beyond me. For now. You and I are in a whole lot of trouble. We need help, and I'm not sure where we'll find it in this wilderness. How about we embark on the quest for a healer together? Most excellent. Then, without further ado, let's be off. Besides, looks like you keep some interesting company. A woman with shadows for eyes, deep as the dark lake. Pleasure, madam.
Is it indeed? We'll see.